We're looking at factors. Now, as we know that factors, these are numbers that can divide the given number. Can divide the given number. For example, if we're given a 20, which numbers can divide 20? Now, these are the samples. Everybody knows 1 can divide a 20 because 20 divided by 1, you'll get 20. 2 can divide 20 because 20 divided by 2, you get 10. 3 cannot properly divide 20, hence we shall skip it. 4, yes, 4 can divide 20 and we shall get 5. And the opposite is true. 5 can divide 20, we shall get 4, we shall have 10 and 20. Now, how do we easily obtain these numbers? We can look at a pair of numbers which can multiply to give these given numbers. For example, we know 1, when you multiply it to 20, you get 20. What another second number can multiply? 2, when you multiply it to 10, you get 20. 3, no. 4, when you multiply it to 5, you get 20. Now, after doing that, you can take all of them and list them like that. This is another easier way of how we can know our factors. Let's look at another example. We can take 50. Now, which numbers can divide 50? Let's look at our second method. What number, when you multiply to 1, you get 50? It will be 50 itself. 2, when you multiply to it 25, will get 50. 3, it's not existing. 4, it will be very small. 5, when you multiply it to 10, you will get 50. 6, no. 7, no. 8, no. 9, no. Hence, 10, we are back to the number. So, we shall take all these numbers and list them up there. 1, 2, 5, 10, 25, and 50. Now, these are the factors of 50. Now, when you look here, among the factors, we also have what we call prime factors. What are prime factors? We have also to know prime factors. These are prime numbers that are within the variable factors. And we know what are prime numbers, right? Numbers that can be divided by 1 and itself only. Now, when we look for in our examples, this is a prime number. 4 is not. 5 is a prime number. And the rest are not. Therefore, in this 20, the prime factors are 2 and 5. Let's look at 50. The prime factors here is a 2 and a 5 again. Therefore, also here we have 2 and 5. Now, let's find another way of how to obtain prime factors. Remember, we can obtain prime factors using what we call factor tree. Let's take again an example of 20. How can we do factor tree of 20? Now, we know 20 divided by 2, it will give us 10. 10 can still be divided by 2 to get 5. Now, We have 2 again, and 5. In this part here, the prime factors are 2 and 5. However, if we wanted to prime factorize, we can state it as 2 times 2 times 5. Now, above, these are prime factors. Below it, we have prime factorized. Let's look at another example, a new number, not 50 again. We can take 100. Let's write the factor tree of 100. By 2, we shall get 50. By 2, 25. By 5, we shall get 5. Now, from this, we can obtain prime factors, and we can prime factorize. Now, what are prime factors there? The prime factors which are existing is a 2 and a 5. 2 and a 5. However, if we prime factorize, we shall get 2 times 2 times 5 times 5. Let's get the last example on this. Let's get a different number. Now, for example, we can take, let's say 49, 45. When we want to put 45 on a factor tree, 2 cannot divide. So we shall start with 3. 3 will give us 15. And again, we shall do 3. 3 will give us 5. Now, from this, we can have our prime factors. And also we can prime factorize. What are prime factors? We have a 3 and a 5. How do we prime factorize this? We shall state 3 times 3 times 5. Now, let's remember something. When we are drawing a factor tree, we can have two types of factor trees. We can have straight away using prime numbers, or we can have a factor tree without prime numbers, but by splitting the value. Let's take an example. What do we mean by splitting? Let's take 100. Instead of starting with prime factors, we can split 100 by saying 10 by 10. And again, we shall factorize this side alone by 2, 5, and this side alone by 2, 5. Now, this is another factor tree by splitting. So, we can have a factor tree by straight away doing the prime numbers, or we can have a factor tree by splitting the values, then you go and split again and again to get them the factors. This is our small chapter about factors, as we have seen. Therefore, if you have enjoyed the discussion, you can like and subscribe to my channel.